monk.
Marry me now.
Soon. Oh, what time is it?
Who cares? Going back to bed.
Oh, it's 10 after. I promised I'd open the office and get to the airport.
Dave, turn off the steam, it's too hot.
I love it.
I can't believe it.
All right. Wait. You wash my back and I'll wash yours.
Oh, you behave yourself. Are you pouting?
Hey, it's not funny. Did you reject me? Soap in my eye in the shower? Send me off to the cruel world without breakfast.
I apologize. I'll make it up to you.
How? I'd really like to know how.
Maybe I could think of something. Let me look at you for a second. You're so handsome.
I know.
Drive carefully and kiss me. All day.
Port of honor.
Did you have a good sleep? Did you dream of Lassie? Have you breakfast?
None, Mr. Atwell. Keep up the good work. Thanks, McCarthy.
Has Flight 72 from L.A. arrived?
On time. 20 minutes ago.
Oh, would you please page a Mr. Wendell Atwell
for
me?
Sure.
Thank you. Never mind, I see him. Sorry I'm late.
Yes, we've nothing to do all day except that rinky-dink job, and you still can't pick me up on time.
Don't ridicule my work. It's important to me and quite a few other people.
If it were important, sweet face, they'd pay you. You get nothing. Of course, you're worth nothing.
I won't dignify that with an answer.
Always the lady, huh? Come on, sweet face, loosen up and call me a shit. It'll make you feel better.
Yeah, how about a belt? It might help.
No, thank you.
Hey, bartender, another double, no ice.
You're making me nervous.
I'm going to Washington tonight.
But you just got in.
Oh, didn't Steve tell you? He arranged a meeting for me with the big boys.
No, he didn't. What about tonight?
What about tonight? You go without me. Steve will take you.
Wendell, they're presenting me with the award. You've known about this for weeks.
Award's my ass. That's rocking horse manure. It's a Ward's thing is nothing more than a come-on to get me to donate more money. Christ, I wouldn't go if I were here. Bunch of blue-blooded jackasses at the club looking for an excuse to get all gussied up and hang one on.
You married me to get into that circle.
Oh, let's not go through that crap again.
I want a divorce, Wendell.
All right, you gotta look solid for the merger.
I've been waiting a year for an imaginary merger.
No kidding. Just don't forget, all of your mother's assets and most of yours are tied up in my company.
I can't stand living this lie.
Who are you sleeping with, sweet face?
It's none of your business as long as I'm discreet, right?
For Christ's sakes, will you take it easy? You are the worst driver. I should have taken away your license, not mine.
Don't criticize my driving. It's the only wifely duty you still require. What do you want, Wendell?
Same as always, fun and games. You know what they say. You separate the men from the boys by the size
and the price of their toys.
How they play with them. Oh, great. Your bleeding eyeballs are going to get us killed one of these days. A real princess.
Order, Mr. Atwell.
Me a new bat.
I'll be home by 4. Anything urgent?
Your lawyer, Mr. Charles Claus.
Oh, great. I don't need that now.
Don't tell him I'm back, huh? Anyone else?
Mr. Kelly Rodriguez.
Rodriguez? I've been waiting for that call. Get him for me right now.
He didn't leave a number. Don't you have it?
Yeah.
Should I list Mr. Rodriguez in your phone index?
No.
Oh, Wendell, welcome back.
Steve. Build me a drink, will you?
Sure, coming up. You look in pretty good shape for someone who's been through the ringer. Did the money come through?
Bet you a sweet ass. Any day I can't handle a bunch of asshole bankers, I'm going to start voting Democratic.
Well, okay, tell me. What'd you say to him?
I told him Washington was tying our hands, that the communists can now paralyze every living thing on this planet for months with an airborne formula dispersed from a satellite, while our yo-yos in the Pentagon with all that spaghetti on their shoulders won't let me make my inhalables any more powerful than a toasted marshmallow.
Well, because you're getting pressure from the ecologists. Don't hurt the wildflowers, the bees, the birds, the butterflies. Hell, what they're looking for are clean germs.
That sounds like bad news for the research lab.
That's right. I'm not carrying the research lab if all they want us to do is give the hoof and mouth disease to a bunch of hamsters. As far as I'm concerned, we're out of biologicals. Get rid of that lab. Fire everybody, now. Problem?
Well, I wasn't aware that being a hatchet man was part of my function here.
Well, you can always go back to your old job in the CIA at that generous salary they were paying you.
Yes, sir?
Did you get Rodriguez?
Not yet, Mr. Atwell.
Keep trying.
Sir, I'll give you all the information you'll need.
What time is the flight?
7:30, I'll be driving.
Yeah.
Mr. Kelly Rodriguez is out of town, Mr. Atwell.
Leave a message on the service?
No, you didn't ask me to.
Well, leave one. Tell him I want to talk to him right now.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and, Christine.
Yes, sir?
Call the florist and have him send some flowers to my wife. A couple of dozen gardenias, huh? Oh, and you better send some flowers to my little friend in L.A.
What kind, sir?
The most expensive kind they've got. Have them sign the usual card for her.
What should they write on your wife's card?
She doesn't get a card.
Yes, Mr. Atwell.
That's a stupid broad.
Hope you don't have a date tonight. You're taking Catherine to the awards banquet.
Oh, that'll be my pleasure.
Yes, sir?
I changed my mind. Have the floor send a card. Signed, your loving husband.
Yes, Miss Dadwell.
Another grabber.
Good to see you. You missed your old man, didn't you, huh? Sure, atta boy. Pack my bag?
Yes.
Oh, Consuelo. I suppose you've been cleaning my office, too, huh?
Si, senor.
And you emptied my wastebasket?
Si, senor.
Damn it, girl, how many times do I have to tell you to stay the hell away from my desk? Don't you understand? No tacho, comprendo nada. No tacho. Have you been here long enough to know better than that girl?
Si, senor.
Around here for 3 weeks, about all she ever remembers is no in casa.
Kathy, how have you been?
I'm fine.
Hey, you got those papers, Steve?
Yeah, right here. Just need a couple of signatures.
Yeah, sign those, huh?
Why?
Because that's where the X is.
Not until I read it first.
Get me a drink, Steve. Make it a double, huh?
I haven't got all day for those papers, huh?
What would you like, Kathy?
Nothing really.
Have one. Might help.
There's some white wine in the fridge.
White wine? That's for faggots and cooking.
Consuelo made some guacamole and chips. You should eat something before you go.
Yeah, I guess I could nibble a little.
Milk.
Mr. Orwell's favorite, but he makes fun of me. He laughs at me all the time.
He doesn't really mean it.
I need to touch his paper, senora, but he makes fun of me all the time.
You should let her go home early.
All right. Consuelo, I'll finish that. You go on home. Don't worry about it. Have a good weekend.
Thank you, senora.
In his bedroom. You let Consuelo go.
Yes, I did. He can be so cruel.
Very beautiful.
Fill me another, will you? Get the flowers I sent you, sweet face?
Yes, thank you, Wendell. They're lovely.
Where are they?
In the kitchen.
Kitchen? You ought to put them out here where people can see them.
Hey, Punch. Oh, ah, come on, Punch. Go get her. Here, boy, come on. Come on, let's have a little action. Get her, Punch. Go on, boy. Don't be lazy. Come on, boy.
Don't let her get away with that. She's making a monkey out of you. He's gaining on you, Judy. Go on. Get her, boy. Get her. Huh? You been feeding these animals?
They look thin.
Yes, of course I have.
Well, I think you ought to feed them more. Dope Washington, huh?
Okay, come on. Yeah. Oh, Judy's such a pretty girl. Come on. How about a little drink?
Wendell. Wendell, I wish you wouldn't do that.
Oh, it keeps them alert. Got life too easy.
A wife who's got nothing to do all day but coddle a bunch of delinquents who ought to be in jail in the first place. Right, Judy? Huh?
Wendell. Let me help you. Oh. Oh, my God. He's having a heart attack.
No, he's not.
This is... It's a disrespect.
I just killed the bastard. Tasteless, odorless, and real fast.
You.
Oh, my God.
Son of a
bitch.
Help me, sweet face. Get me a doctor.
No, it's too late. It's too late.
You're crazy.
Rod Regan.
I can't believe what's happening.
Believe it. Yes. Believe it.
Rest.
He's dead.
Oh, no. No. Please don't die. Oh, God. Don't die.
You tell me you want him back.
I didn't want him killed.
He was killing you day after day, tearing you apart, bleeding you to death.
God, how he enjoyed doing it.
How much more do you think you could have taken before he destroyed you completely? And what do you think would have been left for us?
Oh, Steve.
Cassie. Cassie, I love you.
Just trust me. Do as I say.
I'm so scared. Steve, I'm so scared.
Don't answer me.
Kathy, don't fall apart on me now. Where's Wendell's passport?
In his study. Steve, let's call the police right now.
Okay, Kathy. I can do that. I call the police and tell them we just killed Wendell Atwell. We're guilty. We want to give ourselves up. Is that what you want me to do? There's no way back. If you want to call the police, now's the time.
Okay, that should do it. Now, we're playing it safe. First, I catch the 7:30 flight to Washington as Mr. Wendell Atwell, president of Atwell Industries. I'll be back tomorrow afternoon at 1.
What about Wendell?
Oh, I'll get rid of him tomorrow at the old mine at Wickenburg. No one will ever find him there. And then Sunday, we'll pick up the money from his locker, and we'll go out of town as Mr. and Mrs. Atwell. Here's your passport. And you keep the locker key.
Locker key?
Kathy, listen. There's a bag at the airport with over $1 million in it. Money Wendell used for payoffs, bribes. He always kept at least $1 million at the airport.
There was a contract pending. He'd call it his edge. He even paid off an airport security guard to turn a public locker in his own safety deposit box.
You keep the key. And if anything should go wrong, you go for the money and don't look back. Yeah.
What did you mean when you said nothing can go wrong?
Nothing. Nothing can go wrong. By the time the office opens on Monday, we're gone. Someone's looking for Wendell over the weekend. He's in Washington.
When did you say you're coming back?
I'll be back here tomorrow afternoon.
I can't sleep here tonight.
Kathy, nothing can hurt you. Nothing. The dog's here. You'll be at the banquet all night. When you come back, just take something to help you sleep.
Oh, I can't go to the banquet.
Yes, you will go.
No.
If you seem nervous, so much the better. They'll think it's because of the award they're giving you.
Oh, I can't go through with it.
Try, Kathy. I want you to try. This is our one chance, Kathy. Let's not blow it.
Atwell worked untiringly when others faltered. It was through her efforts we were able to buy the building. Hope House will be a haven for the adolescent girls of the community who need our help. Kathy, we are proud to give you this plaque. The state of Arizona honors Catherine Atwell for her distinguished and dedicated service to the community of Hope House. We are sorry Wendell couldn't be here tonight to share in your glory.
First of all, I'd like to thank you for this wonderful award. I'll always treasure it as a symbol of the important work being done at Hope House. Our open door policy welcomes all adolescent girls in trouble. We give them counseling, guidance, and sometimes just a good old-fashioned push in the right direction. At a time in their lives when they think nobody cares, we show them we care. I'm proud of Hope House and of you for the money you've given to keep it going. All of our girls join me in thanking you from the bottom of our hearts.
Nice smile. That's...
Kathy, what's that?
No, thank you.
Oh, it's a command. I just wrote out a $5,000 check to Hope House. You owe me.
Oh, come on. Kathy, come on. Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
I wish you'd reconsider my standing offer.
Bob, Bravo, Kathy. Bravo.
Thank you.
We send Monica and Wendell off to a distant planet in a faulty spaceship. Then you and I take a lease on the Taj Mahal. And every morning I have them deliver a blanket of rose petals for us to lie on when we make love. I don't think I've ever seen you look so damn sexy.
Herbert, go get me a brandy. Be a good boy. Yeah.
Still owe me half the balance. I'll collect later.
Kathy, is there anything the matter with you?
Monica, no, I wanted to talk to you about the expenses for the banquet.
Alice, please excuse us. I want to be alone
with
Kathy.
Oh, of course.
Sure, Catherine.
Huh? No, thank you. I don't want it.
Please, just a sip.
No.
Would you like me to take you home?
Herbert, I have my car.
No, no, don't worry about the car. I'd be glad to
she
take
said,
you.
No, Herbert. Herbert, you owe me a few.
Ah, yeah.
Congratulations, Kathy.
Yes, that's sweet.
Congratulations, Kathy. You won this speech.
Well done, yes, Kathy. We're all very proud.
Much better, so it looks like I'm gonna have to be in Denver till the end of the month. I hope they took pictures at the banquet. Kate, you know I would have been there if I wasn't needed here. So, goodbye, kitten.
Favor. All very immediate, Actwell urgency. I mean, drop everything so that the Actwell Industries come first in its hour of need. Well, I missed the big antique auction so that I finish the work on time. And of course, he doesn't call me. He leaves town today without seeing me. And to compound the felony, I have three messages for him today. He didn't even answer one of them. How can you stand him? How can you stand such a man? The only reason I don't fire him as a client is you, my pretty.
Oh.
To us. Hmm? Mm. Drink up. It is full of French vitamins.
Please. Go home.
What is there? Nothing at home. Monica, she's such a bore.
Oh, no, she isn't, Herbert. Oh,
we'd be very good together. Just
Herbert.
Like you and Wendell used to be good together.
Herbert, go home. You're drunk. Don't, you're drunk. Oh! Oh! Cowboy, down, cowboy! Cowboy, no, down. Stay. Did he break the skin?
Oh, Herbert, I'm sorry.
I'll live to love again. My favorite champagne. It's rather an expensive antiseptic, but I'm worth it.
Statwell. I'm Lieutenant Donner.
Police Department. May I come in?
What is it, Lieutenant?
Well, I'm here about your husband. We received a missing persons report on him.
Missing? Who reported him missing?
A Miss Christine Wheeler. She's supposed to be his secretary. She was to hear from him last night, and when she hadn't heard by this morning, she called us.
But my husband's in Washington. He left last night. She knew that.
She thinks he might be carrying a great deal of money. Have you talked to him?
Yes, I have.
What time did he call?
Earlier.
Specifically?
I think it was around 10 o'clock.
Have you been here all morning?
Yes, I have.
When I called, there was no answer.
I must have been in the shower.
Four times?
I was also outside with my dog.
When you talked with Mr. Atwell, was there anything unusual about the conversation?
No, I don't think so.
Did he tell you where he was staying?
Actually, he didn't, but he usually stays at the Senator.
Miss Wheeler called the Senator. He's not registered there. What time was his flight last night?
7:30.
7:30. I see. Well, good. I guess that'll be about all. Mr. Hunter, you or Mr. Atwell?
Neither. They were his mothers.
Expensive sport. In Rosewood, right?
Yes.
It's walnut, colored with bichromate to make it look like rosewood.
Why did they do that?
Money. In the 18th century, a carpenter could feed his family for a month on the difference between a few planks of walnut and rosewood.
Are you a collector?
Not on my salary. Now, I have a little shop, and I do some repair work and carpentry. My father was a cabinet maker. He taught me. I built his coffin. Well, I won't keep any longer. I will verify the Senator Hotel. Thank you for your time.
Goodbye, Lieutenant.
Continental Airlines, can I help you?
Yes, has the 12:30 flight from Washington, D.C. landed?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, it has. When?
20 minutes ago.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, this is Steve Fulton.
Steve!
I'm not in right now, but if you leave your name, number, and message, I'll be sure to get right back to you.
Hello.
It's Lieutenant Donner, ma'am.
Yes, Lieutenant.
We're having a little trouble, Mrs. Atwell. Your husband never did check into the Senator. When he called, was it collect?
No.
The Washington police are checking other hotels for us. Do you know who he was going to see in Washington?
No, I don't.
What did the secretary know?
I don't know. Maybe.
If it's convenient, Mrs. Atwell, I'd like to stop around tonight about 9 after dinner and have a look around.
Lieutenant, I have plans. I'm going out.
Aren't you concerned about your husband, Mrs. Atwell? Because we are.
Yes, of course I am.
Well, then change your plans, ma'am. I'll be out for a thorough look around.
Exactly what will you be looking for?
Something that might give us an answer as to his whereabouts.
I don't know.
I'll be there with a search warrant.
Ah!
Oh.
You're not going to wear that to the ballet.
Oh, Monica, I completely forgot.
Hurry up. I'll call Alice and tell her we'll pick her up in 20 minutes. And we'll be fashionably late.
Oh, no. No, I'm not going.
Kathy, if I had known you weren't coming, I could have taken half a dozen people who were fainting to go. Why didn't you call me?
I'm sorry, Monica.
You're behaving very irresponsibly lately.
I really don't feel well. I just don't feel well.
Everyone in Phoenix is talking about you. Get rid of Steve Fulton. He's a nothing.
No, don't say that.
Believe me, you can do better. In the future, be discreet, darling. When you're having an affair, you don't have him pick you up from your office. Alice has a big mouth.
I see my husband's been here.
Oh, Monica, it's not what you think. Herbert stopped by uninvited and I sent him away. He was drunk. Monica, let me talk to you. Don't go. Monica, please let me explain. Don't run away. I need you.
Get rid of Steve Fulton.
I'll be there with a search warrant.
Arizona honors Catherine Atwill.
There's no way back.
I'll be out and have a thorough look around.
I'll get rid of him tomorrow at the old mine at Wickenburg. Wickenburg.
Let's go on through. Come on, come on. Keep it moving, please. Watch it around that bend, sir. Hold it right there, ma'am. All right, let's go on around. Something wrong, miss?
I'm sorry. My car. I can't get my car started.
Watch it, lady.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'd like to talk to you, Mrs. Atwell.
You told me you'd be here at 9.
Well, something's come up. What are their names?
Punch and Judy.
Aren't they hard to take care of?
No.
Mrs. Atwell, have you heard from your husband?
No, I haven't.
We checked the airport, and he never made that flight last night.
Well, maybe he took another flight.
If he did, there's no record of it.
But I talked to him.
He could have been calling from anywhere. Mrs. Atwell, I'd like your permission to search his office.
Well, I can't do that.
Your husband is into biological defense. There are a lot of people in this country who are not too thrilled by that particular line of work. Has his life ever been threatened?
I don't know.
Does he have any enemies?
I don't know.
We may have to call in the FBI.
Sorry to bother you so late, Mrs. Atwell, but he has this official paper with your name on it. I see. Yes, Lieutenant Donner. Okay, just thought I would check.
Who's in charge here when Mr. Atwell's away?
Steve Fulton.
Would you write down his name and address? I'll pick it up on the way out.
And how long will you be?
Not long.
All right, when you're ready to go, dial me on 2 and I'll let you out.
Right.
Could you tell me your latest flight to Denver tonight?
Yes, ma'am. 8:30.
All right, that'll be fine.
May I have your name?
Mrs. Catherine Atwell.
Okay, you're confirmed on that flight.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Here's your change, Mrs. Atwell. Flight 274 to Denver is at gate 11 in 15 minutes.
Thank you very much.
Hi. Can I help you?
Mr. Medford, this is Catherine Atwell. I'm going to be out of town for a few days, and I was wondering if you could pick up the animals tonight. I know it's last minute and late. I left the key under the mat. They've been fed. I understand. Yes, tomorrow will be fine. I'll call you from Denver when I'm coming home. Thank you.
Will Mr. Wendell Atwell please report to the nearest courtesy telephone? Mr. Wendell Atwell.
Oh.
Sorry. Oh, Miss, wait. Good thing. Wait.
Are you all right?
I'm fine.
You sure?
Right, are you
sure? We'll have you for you in just a minute.
Thank you.
Dandruff.
Biffy, listen, this car, Hitler gave Stalin to buy his friendship.
Okay, little shoulder.
Stalin
right, love.
Loved it. Smuggled out of Russia by a Swedish linguist named Johansson. Now, let me show you this. This was Roosevelt's car. See? Presidential seal. It's completely bulletproof.
What kind of car is it?
Packard, 12 cylinders.
What kind of mileage does it get?
I think it does about 1 mile to the gallon, which explains why they don't make it anymore.
Blue, sir. Nice. Ooh. Very good.
Biffy, this is a must. This is Hitler's personal car.
Operator, get me the police.
Phoenix Police, Sergeant Lally.
Lieutenant Donner, please.
I'll transfer you. Tell Donner to answer his phone.
He hasn't come in yet, Sarge.
Turn off his light, for Christ's sake. Lieutenant Donner is out. Can somebody else help you?
Excuse me. Hello?
Monica, may I speak to Herbert?
One moment.
I don't understand. If they'll contribute to...
Excuse me.
Why not?
You don't understand. Joni and I...
Melinda, I do understand. You don't get any response.
Herbert! There's a phone call.
Fine.
The goal is $250,000.
I think it's lovely. Hello?
Herbert, this is Catherine. The other night, I...
Look, I've already forgotten that. I've really got to go, Catherine.
No, Herbert, I need to see you.
The essence of life is timing. It's too late.
Oh, no, Herbert, I'm in trouble.
What have you done, Kathy?
I can't talk about it on the phone, Herbert.
Why not? Do you live in New York?
The police. They're coming over here, and I don't know what to tell them.
Tell them nothing. Get rid of them. I'll see you tomorrow morning. My office, 9 o'clock, all right?
No, Herbert!
Now, I've really got to go now. Bye, Kathy.
Oh, God.
Is Mr. Medford in? This is Catherine Atwell. Would you please tell him that there's been a change of plans? That's right. He won't have to pick up the animals anymore. Thank you very much. Bye. Who is it?
It's Lieutenant Donner, ma'am.
I tried to reach you this morning. Did you find out about Wendell?
I told you everything I knew last night. There's no record of your husband taking a flight anywhere. The Washington police have not been able to locate him in any hotel. The one thing I am sure of is that your husband did not leave Phoenix unless he drove. You call my office? Is there something else you wanted to talk about?
Oh, I just wanted to know about my husband.
Mrs. Atwell, I'm going to ask you a very sensitive question. Are you and your husband having domestic difficulties?
No.
You weren't planning to go out, were you?
I may.
Well, if you don't mind, I'd like to take a good look around. Ever hear of a fellow called Kelly Rodriguez?
No.
Found this in your husband's desk. Check stub for $1,000 made out by Mr. Atwell to Mr. Rodriguez. I'd like that back, please. Kelly Rodriguez is a private detective from Tucson.
Atwell Industries uses a lot of security people.
No, he's not the corporation type. I know him from the police department here. He specializes in bedroom pictures, divorce cases, things like that.
I've never heard of him.
I can't put it together, man, like Rodriguez. Have you seen anybody hanging around? He's thin, dark, about 50. Half Irish, half Spic. Mexican.
No. If that's all, will you please excuse me?
You bet. When was the last time you saw Steve Fulton?
Friday. He drove Wendell to the airport.
And he was the last person to see your husband?
Yeah, I guess. Why?
We can't locate him. Mr. Fulton's disappeared. I'll be in touch.
Sweet face. Get a doctor, help me. Help me. Get a doctor, sweet face, help me. Help.
To give it back to you, senora. I had to go to the doctor because
he said that I have a alta presión, high blood pressure. But my husband don't want me to work for you no more. He says that your husband is mal hombre. He's not good. But you, senora, you're usted muy buena.
There was someone in this house. I know there was someone in this house.
Well, whoever it was, he's not here now.
You must believe me. He killed my dog and the monkeys.
I checked every room. I just came back from Tucson. Had a long talk with Kelly Rodriguez. Your husband hired him. He He's had this house bugged for weeks. I heard the tapes with you and Mr. Fulton. I heard everything.
Well, then you know I didn't kill my husband.
Doesn't make a damn bit of difference whether you did it together or not. You didn't call us. That makes you an accessory. Hello. Let me speak with Detective Brock, please. Hello, Brock. It's Donner. Listen, I want you to come out to the Atwell house. Yeah, right away.
Yeah. Yeah, the coroner. Everything, yeah, that's it.
No, no, no. Try and keep them away.
All right. You're gonna have to have a lawyer. Do you have one?
Yes. Herbert Childs.
You got a number?
998-5509, that's his home. And his office is 957-5000.
The reporters and television people are gonna be there when we get downtown. I'll call your lawyer for you. Why don't you go take a shower and freshen up a little?
Oh, and we're going to need that key to the locker so they can pick up the money. Are you all right?
Brock, sorry to keep you hanging on for so long. Look, I'll need a car to go out to the airport with a couple of fellas to pick up that money. Yeah, you notify the DA. Okay, you can save me some time. Tell the coroner it was a poisoning. Yeah, we want forensic to do an autopsy. Yeah, he's been dead over 72 hours. You bet, Brock. Tell the boys to bring out some heavy plastic bags. There's some dead animals up here. They're pretty messy. I'd like to get them out of here for her. This woman's been through pure hell. Hold on.
Okay, well, when you get here...
Yeah? Okay.
Help me!
house. I know there was someone in this house.
Well, whoever it was, he's not here now.
But you must believe me. He killed my dog and the monkeys.
I checked every room. I just came back from Tucson. I had a long talk with Kelly Rodriguez. Your husband hired me. He's had this house bugged for weeks. I heard the tapes with you and Mr. Fulton. I heard everything.
Then you know I didn't kill my husband.
Doesn't make a damn bit of difference whether you did it together or not. You didn't call us. That makes you an accessory. Hello. May I speak to Detective Brock, please? Hello, Brock. Good honor. Listen, I want you to come out to the Admiral House. Yeah, right away.
And 30
yeah.
seconds.
Yeah, coroner. Everything. Yeah, that's it. No. Try and keep them away. You're gonna have to have a lawyer. If you have one.
Yes. Herbert Childs.
At the tone, the time will be.
You got a number?
998-5509. That's his home. And his office.
Time and some more, Mr. Fulton.
Thank you.
You've got 25 minutes, gate 11.
Phoenix Police, Sergeant Lolly.
I'd like to speak with Lieutenant Donner, please.
This is Lieutenant Donner.
I want to report a murder.
Who is this, please?
My name is Steve Fulton. That's right. 2131 Edgemont Drive.
Oh, hold on just a second. Were you a witness?
Not exactly.
Then how do you know?
Because I killed him. My flight's already been called. Did you hurry?
Did you rent the car here?
No, Tucson.
That will be $245 based upon 1 week's rental.
My pleasure.
We try harder. Have a nice trip, Mr. Rodriguez.
You bet.
Excuse me. Would you come with me, please?
My name is Steve Fulton. I work for Mr. Wendell Atwell.
So do I. Would you come with me, please? Step this way.
United Airlines, Mainliner Service, flight 644 for Grand Rapids,
Flint, you're McCarthy, right? Got a message for you from Mr. Atwell.
Where's Mr. Atwell?
He's under investigation. He can't come here anymore. Sent me down here to clear out his locker. I'm the vice president of the company.
How do I know you're telling the truth?
Asked me to give you this. He won't be using his locker anymore.
Okay.
Information.